So we're still asking questions about the whole of Paul's letter to the Romans. And what we noticed last week was that there were two big problems here. There was the first problem in the first section, the problem of sin, that related to the guilt of sin and the wrath of God that follows our guilt. And then there was the second problem, which was the problem of the corruption of sin and of death. So the wrath of God and then the corruption of sin, which leads to death. And the task I gave you was to see if there was any logic between why these two things are ordered the way they are. In other words, could we just flip them and it make no difference to the argument that say the wrath of God was to be the second thing Paul addressed and the corruption and death of sin is the first thing Paul addresses? Would that in any way matter? And the answer is yes, it would matter. But before we even get to the order of them, let's first address the fact that there are indeed two problems for every individual regarding sin. And if you don't, and it's crucial that you understand each person has not just one problem with relation to sin, but two different problems. For example, let's say somebody is forgiven of their guilt. Let's say they're a violent thief and they're forgiven of their sin. Okay? So that's great. That's fantastic. Hallelujah. They're forgiven. And let's say they're eternally forgiven and they're going to be in heaven. And so that problem has been dealt with. But they continue to live the rest of their life on a weekly basis as a violent thief. Well, that wouldn't be good news. That would hardly qualify as the gospel, particularly since the violent thief probably wants, if they sought forgiveness at all, they want in some way to be delivered from their violence and thievery. So it wouldn't really be much good news if the salvation that God provides only leads to forgiveness. It has to do this second thing of actually delivering us from the corruption and the power of sin that leads to death, and again, death in a more generic sense of robbing us of the fullness of life. So there has to be two problems solved in order for there to be truly good news for the world. Now, does it matter that the wrath bit comes first, our guilt comes first, and then God deals with the sort of power and of sin, the corruption of sin? And the answer is yes. I had a friend in high school that was driving his car out on the side of a golf course and crashed it. And so the car was a wreck. And you would think this is a really big problem because you can't get the car off the golf course since it's sort of wrecked. But there was a bigger problem, and that was that the car wasn't my friend's. It belonged to his dad. So once you hear that piece of the story, you realize that his first problem is not the fact that the car is a wreck, that the car has been sort of corrupted and doesn't work. The problem is first that he has to deal with his father at the personal level. And once he deals with his father and finds forgiveness with his father, it's actually in God, it's in his father, in this analogy, his father is God, that he discovers there are resources to help him overcome the power and the corruption of sin. So you can't get these things in reverse. You can't go to God to try and fix your life and overcome the power of sin, and then later, as an afterthought, think, you know, maybe God might be justifiably upset with your rebellion and disobedience. It doesn't work this way. You have to go the other way around. But it's also true that you can't simply come to God for forgiveness and not have that secondary thing of a commitment of a life of obedience where God provides the resources through his Spirit, and on a daily basis you overcome the power of sin. So that was the first task you had for this week, and now the task you have, the second one, I guess, for next week, is we're going to move on to this third section in Romans, which has to do largely with the nation of Israel. It's not so much our personal problem anymore. It's a problem that relates to that nation. And so the question is, what is that problem? So you're going to sort of trace that problem through this section here in chapters 9, 10, and 11, and what solution God has for that problem. So that's what'll keep you busy, I think, easily for another week. And I wish you the best, and I'll see you next week.